It's the end of the week, and so it's time to take out the trash. Brett, the first, I think, garbage person of the new year, who are you choosing?
You know, the weather outside is frightful, so scare it back. Dana Perino, former White House press secretary, I want to say now she's in Fox News. She was the one that got away from MSNBC, has attacked when she saw people backed up in a traffic jam for hours and hours, bleeding into multiple days. She did not talk about this, the roads, climate change, weather, anything like that. She decided to blame it on folks not letting police officers have tanks.
I talked to a state legislator there in Virginia, and he pointed out to me that in the last several years, many on the left made a decision that local sheriffs should not be allowed to have military grade equipment, right? Because they said that that was a bad symbol and that it was too militaristic and authoritarian. But imagine if they were still allowed to have the equipment that they had just a few years ago, it probably would have come in very helpful today.
Someone told me, pointed it out, and it probably would have come in handy. Why don't you know that now? What equipment, lady? Was there a snowblower 800,000 nuclear powered, like what is it? Like radioactive plutonium that would have somehow melted it? It's just because it's snow. Do you think it can be melted by yelling fire with like a giant Gatling gun, 50 cal weapon? What are you talking about? Do you think that like have a nice day tank that's supposed to go through like a hostage crisis, you know, battened down hatches is the thing that's gonna get rid of this kind of blockage to the thoroughfare?
There's
tons of other stupid crap people are talking about along these lines, but that is by far the absolute craziest. And when this is the ultimate, like when you have a hammer, everything looks like a nail. When you want a police state and you want the police to have military grade weapons, those military grade weapons will solve everything, even a traffic jam.
Yeah, it's a nonsensical point. I don't like the initial crash. We just need to flatten those cars with tanks, then we could drive over them. Or would he clear away the snow with Agent Orange? I don't understand what point she's making, which is the only thing I have in common with her. It's the sort of thing, like we were criticizing this on Twitter on the main show yesterday, where like if you're not actually clever, just relate something in the news to a different thing, and that's supposed to stand in for being clever. We'll do that in the news too. I know, okay, so this is about like an infrastructure problem and us not being ready for snow. So militarization of the police, why not? You can tie it to literally anything. Maybe they play a game before they go on the air. They have to pull two random issues from a jar and they have to tie them together some way. But it certainly didn't make any sense and it's not helpful.
It's just sad because like that side of the aisle should probably say something like, this is an argument for privatizing roads, because if you leave it to the government, they won't fix any. Like at least those old arguments, use ones that are tangentially related, not like they should have bigger guns. Local sheriffs should have giant tanks at every turn so that in places where it snows, they can use those somehow to clear the roads. Like
similarly, I saw someone who attempted to use this to attack electric cars. They said, can you imagine if this had happened and those cars had been electric? And I thought, what, would they have been stopped and not able to move? That's what happened. That's actually what happened already. It's like the right wingers who like in 2020 were taking images of empty shelves and saying, this is what'll happen under socialism. No, that's what happened now. That is already the thing that happened. Why are you not criticizing? Why are you coming up with hypotheticals when you have a perfectly good thing to criticize right here?
Did you see the supply chain photos where they're like, this is a CVS and the totally empty shelves thanks to Biden's supply chain problem? And it was the seasonal aisle that they empty anyway, so that they can bring in like, all right, there's a week before we get our
Easter in.
We get our Valentine's Day sweet tart shipment.
Yep, that's pathetic.
Check out the Damage Report podcast each day, wherever you get your podcasts, whether Pocket Casts or Stitcher or iTunes. You can join me as I give you the news and stories you want, with a range of co-hosts and interview guests jumping in on the fun each day. Again, that's the Damage Report, wherever you get your podcasts. And if you get them at iTunes, don't forget to rate and review. Sometimes I'll read them live on the show.